Previously on Let's Play Adventure Mode, I died, killed by a bear, Bangle Harry Basements is no more. And to those of you who aren't familiar with Dwarf Fortress Adventure Mode, when you die, you are dead. Dead, dead, dead. He's gone, never to be again. And Grizzly Bear is slowly dying before me, hopefully. But for now, let us have a moment of silence for Bangle Harry Basements. Enough of that crap. Alright. Finish game. Yes. The end of Bangle Harry Basements. But he is gone, but not forgotten. For the world will remember him. So let's go to Legends now and see if we had an impact on this little world of ours. You know, we did some cool stuff. Let's see here. Age of Heroes. I wonder if it was the Age of Heroes before I got here. Historical figures. Bangle Harry Basements. He was a human born in 183. He was of unknown parentage. God. Whoever they were, they must have been awesome. Guided by forces unknown. That's me. In the early spring of 206, Bangle began wandering the wilds. In the mid-spring of 206, Bangle mortally wounded the Sasquatch Smoothness Humor, who bled to death in the Hungry Abyss. If I remember, we choked him out with a turban. Mortally wounded the Cyclops Nong Nob, who bled to death. Another strangling. In the mid-spring of 206, Bangle became a mercenary for the Coalition of Muscles. Bangle began worshipping Ulit Moisten Sprays, the washed wisps of roots. Became a member of the Faith of Mist, became a mercenary for the group of prisons. In the mid-spring of 206, Bangle was struck down by the grizzly bear, Dirge Rumor, in the Rumor Jungle. Dirge Rumor, I gotta remember that. I need to go see if I can hunt him down. So, I started in the early spring, and I made it all the way to the mid-spring, which is not very far. I worshipped a dubious god. I was a member of some kingdoms. I got a few notable kills. 4 troglodytes, 1 cave swallow man, 1 wolf that I pierced in the heart. Oh no, that's 3 wolves there. So yeah, not too bad for a little adventure mode action. But the thing about adventure mode is, once you die, you get to start all over again. Yay! Okay, so let's play some more Dwarf Fortress Adventure Mode, and this time let's be an elf, because elves are fruitcakes, and that's about all there is to it. I'm going to start in the southeast corner of the map over there. Let's try using a weapon this time. Last time we were all wrestly and goofy. Be an elven swordsman, shield-using beat machine. Alright. Armor, typical sort of warrior. I do want to put a couple points in wrestling, ambushing, and throwing, because I'm still going to use those skills. I need to put a couple points in swimming, because I don't want to drown. And the more points you put into a skill, the better equipment you start with. So I'm going to put more points into armor user, so I can start with better armor. And I'll put another point in wrestling, because that's hard to train. Human? Oh, I thought I picked an elf, but I guess I picked a human. In a jewel sticks. Okay, we'll be a human, because I don't feel like putting those stat points in again. Sister Struck. Izum Scorched Chance. Rin Iron Grow. Itki Wayward Fame. Thad Swallowed Wayward. Ursi Ward Cooked. Ganu Steak Profits. Addy Blow Jungle. it's not the best, but I'll take it. Let's go. Alright, Addy Blow Jungle. Alright, see, now there, you see, we have a human swordsman. Addy Blow Jungle. I start out with an iron sword, iron shield, some iron armor, chainmail, leggings, stuff like that. Got some muskox meat and some water. I've got different gear this time because I'm in a different civilization. So I'm a swordsman this time. I should be able to do way better. Let's talk to this guy. Greetings. Hello. Oxit wordy problem. Oh man, he's gonna have a hard time explaining this to me. Life isn't a word, justice. Okay. Let's see what kind of services you need. Oh, I started out in a peaceful, shady village with nothing. I'm gonna jump off this balcony here because I don't feel like going down the stairs. Stunned, you slam into an obstacle. That's not an obstacle, that's the floor. So it's sort of like a, kind of like a desert town this time. Oh hey, looks like I can walk on top of this. Oh, underneath this apartment complex here. Okay, well, there's nothing really for me in this town, so looks like there's a road going towards some other towns over here. I'm gonna travel to the coast, see if I can get some nice ocean missions going on. Probably not. There's an elven town to the north, and there's nothing more awesome in this game, or really any game, than killing elves. This is a major city here, paint combined. I'm gonna go into this major city and see if they have any painted... Ooh, this place is called the Prairie of Strangling. Sounds like my kind of place. What's up, Elite Crossbowman? Match onions? Praise be to the eye of the virtuous ward. Praise be to it. Oh, he's got a job for me. Awesome. Our people have been tormented by a fearsome foe. Escort Echo. Day's travel to the northwest. Kill Iseth Agadimon, the Rapid Year, the Cyclops. Knowing no mercy, Iseth destroyed our homes. Killed seven. Or no, he killed nine in her lust for murder. She killed nine. She. Speak the praises of the Eye of Virtuous Ward. Hey everybody, check out the Eye of the Virtuous Ward. It is praiseworthy somehow. Alright, so you know, our last adventure, when we had to kill another Cyclops, that went pretty well. And previously, I didn't have a sword. This time, I have a sword. So we should be able to do much better this time. So, it doesn't really look like there's much going on there. No, it's not on the ocean, but it'll do. And travel through this desert prairie here and go find me some Cyclops. Let's see here. Oh, how familiar this all is. It's like we've been here before. But one of the other cool things is that this all sort of takes place in the same world as the other one. So, you know, at some point, I really will be able to go up and kill that bear that killed me and exact my revenge on him, because I frankly want to. So, yeah, I'm gonna cut the video here, and at some point I'll be able to find the Cyclops. So I will start it again there, and then I will end it, and then I will continue it again in the next one, or something like that. Yeah. See you next time! Okay, I have found the cave where our Cyclops will most likely be hiding, and in the next Let's Play Dwarf Fortress Adventure mode, I'll see if this guy can survive more than one encounter like the previous guy did. Or maybe I'll die. I don't know. Anyway, see you next time.